Astrodemons, the bind of the sign, the season, the reason, and the spirit. This isn't the part I want you to focus on, but this is just going to be helpful to the lesson. Some you'll bind to water. There are marine spirits. Some you bind to earth, beneath the earth, in the pit, the abyss. These dimensional places and spaces also have a physical relationship to that spiritual reality. That is that space and place. There's always something that matches in the physical. So, you know, when you see the depictions of Hades or Sheol, or, you know, I know there's debate about, you know, Sheol is something different than the traditional belief of what hell is, but my point being, there are certain things that must be bound to the earth, even if it is deep within. And then there are certain things that are to be bound, or that come from, certain spirits come from the astral, or what we call, generally, outer space, the prince of the power of the air. So, and you know, there's evidence of all of these. And then there's the jinn, which they talk about in Islam. And that is the, you know, just in a nutshell, Arabic word for demon, jinn. Jinn make you sin. But the jinn is said to be of smokeless fire. So it's interesting here, you have the four so-called elements that make up the astrological elements that go along with what one calls one's sign. Now, we're gonna look at the bind that you get in when you make subconscious agreement with your sign. But first, always, the word of the true and living God. Deuteronomy 18, verse 9. When thou art come into the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations. There shall not be found among you any one that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire. That was as an offering into the fire. Okay, because once you pass through the fire, you expire. But offerings to Moloch and such and different pagan deities would be made using the children, usually the firstborn, or that useth divination. Okay, any sort of divination, lots of different forms of divination, palm reading, a variety of different things fall in that category. You can look that up to get a complete picture of all of the things that fall up under that crystal mancy, all your mancies, or an observer of times. What does that mean? Or an enchanter or a witch, or a charmer or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord, and because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee. Thou shalt be perfect with the Lord thy God. Aren't you told all the time, oh man, nobody's perfect? Well, the Father demands perfection. But now, let's look. Correction helps to bring that perfection. As, you know, the Lord leads you, he does correct you, and you have to be willing to take that correction. And don't take it in the spirit of rejection or resentment or bitterness and offense, okay? Correction is not meant to do that. Correction, you know, when it's properly given and properly received, it's a two-way street. Correction should be about bringing one closer to that divine perfection, which can be attained. But let's look at a couple things here. I noted. For one, I noted that it was not the person who would go to get the service that was seen as the bigger culprit. According to these lists here, these are the people who are rendering the service. The actual charmer, the actual wizard, the consulter with familiar spirits, not the person who pays them to get the consultation. So again, that person does not escape responsibility either. However, the responsibility is greater because of this reality. The Most High was condemning these practicers of these things, and in so doing, those who went to them also would be judged accordingly, okay? But the practitioners themselves were under the powers of evil spirits. And what makes a spirit evil? A malevolent spirit, a negative entity, one that means you harm. One that wishes to drain you, a vampire entity, a being whose being is dependent upon your energy, a parasitic vampirical entity called many different names in many different cultures. But for the purpose of overstanding and understanding here, you know, we all just make it clear, demons. Now, have you ever renounced your sign? Is that a funny question? That's an odd question. You didn't hear me. Have you ever renounced your sign? I'm not talking about you being a practitioner or a consumer. A person that just buys a little keychain that says Leo. The question, have you ever renounced your sign, is important because of this question. Have you ever accepted your sign? If you've ever accepted your sign, then you have made subconscious agreement with the spirits that are behind the sign. So now it's time to bind the sign, okay? And we're going to look at that. The season, the reason, and the spirit. Okay. And just one note. I want to thank the Most High, True and Living, for giving me the verbiage and the utterance and for leading me to put together the puzzle pieces that said that the way that the black and pink agenda would marry and then take this whole thing to the next level as far as police brutality would be once a black, gay, or lesbian had been assaulted by the police and the media picks up on the story, then this will bring together the Black Lives Matter and the pink hand. And they will join hands. And that is a move, a chess move of the enemy, much deeper than many, I think, overstand. But now it is going down in Brooklyn. I'm going to do a news thing. There's so much news going on that it's not feasible to even skim through it and just pick through certain stories, because every day there's so much more going on. So, you know, the Steve Harvey thing, which was about Columbia, Columbine, Columbus discovering quote-unquote America, and even Freeman Fly back in 2010 or 2009, I had a DVD from the Knowledge Man, Brother Band, who put together the best knowledge DVDs in the city. Well, he had a good one with some Freeman Fly on there. And on one of the shows, it was breaking down the Mother Goddess and its connection to Columbia, which was something that I had also read in some Dr. York scroll, but had totally forgotten about it or didn't even know how to apply that knowledge. But yeah, so that was about, you know, the Mother Goddess thing. I mean, of course, you're crowning a woman Miss Universe, you know, Queen of the Universe, or you know, Mother Goddess, Queen of Heaven, quote unquote, symbology. And that's all that was about. And then Steve Harvey, non-spelling, non-talking self, could have just made a mistake. And although autocorrect would have probably gave him a clue, you know, somehow or another, he not only misspells Columbia, but he also misspells Philippines as Philippians, which happens to be a chapter in scripture. And, you know, some may want to comb Philippians and find out the connection to that. I don't feel the need to do that. I see the bottom line of it was the symbolism that many of us were looking for. Whenever you see any celebration or crowning of a woman, be it a queen's coronation or a so-called Miss Universe pageant, it's all about celebrating the Mother Goddess, the mother of harlots, their Queen of Heaven, celebrated also by the Catholic Church, disguised as Mary. Okay, but the season, the reason, and the spirit. So yeah, news coming, and also something else on sports coming. Something else on sports coming for the brothers. I did get a hold of my cousin I was trying to get last time. I told y'all, as far as doing some sports, he's the truth, and he showed and proved. So I'm just putting together the pictures and things to spice it up and nice it up. But you know, it's lightweight jamming. Sports is, but a lot of people are interested in it, and we talk about that too, why that's so. But that's the next one to go. And Brother Charles too, coming with some more, of course. But to bind the sign, everyone knows your sign. You know your sign, okay? Now, to everything there's a season and a reason and a spirit. The signs are named for spirits. This is the problem after the fact. What do you mean? I mean, first there was the season. Let's look and see what happened in the beginning. Then the afterthought was to name the season some antichrist spirit, some spirit. And of course, that came from the influence of the fallen ones, according to the book of Enoch. I can almost call his name. Rogael or something. But yes, one of the fallen angels, and don't quote me on that, on what the name was right now. I'm looking up something else. But one of the fallen angels helped to twist up God's intention again for nature and then feed it back to man, tainted. Same way he did with the herbs and things that grow in the ground for medicinal purposes that have been turned into psychotropic drugs. Basically, psychological warfare is waged, and biological and chemical warfare is waged all through the fallen angels' manipulation of God's creation from the very bottom to the top. From the very bottom to the top, from the things that grow in the ground to the things that go up in space and the things that happen up in quote-unquote so-called space in that plane of existence in that part of the quote-unquote heavens. But let's look and see here. It's 1 and 14. Genesis chapter 1 verse 14. You want to see what happened in the beginning? Let's start in the beginning. And God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years, and let them be for lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth. And it was so. All right, light upon the earth. Light also is always used, or is generally used, to describe revelation as well. Okay, the Ancient of Days of Revelation is the light. Okay. Now, also, and the truth, believe that. And God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs. What type of signs? And for seasons. What does that mean? Certain things grow in certain seasons. Certain plants are seasonal. Correct? My botanists out there. Certain plants grow in certain seasons. Okay? The appearance of certain animals is seasonal, right? You see the yellow jackets, that's what we used to call them. Now they call them wasps. I remember we all called them yellow jackets, but you see those for certain seasons. Then they begin to die out, and them last ones be so mad and the honoriest things on earth at that time. They ain't trying to go. Got to go, Robin Harris. But everything has a season. We also find this in Ecclesiastes. Okay, to everything there is a season, said Shlomo. Well, what does this mean about seasons and for days and years? We understand that that's to divide up quote unquote time, right? Which is, you know, something other than what we think it is, but that's another day. But it says, and let them be for signs. Now again, he don't mean zodiac signs. Zodiac. He's not talking about your zodiac sign, but everybody knows their zodiac sign. So what is the correlation here? What people will say is, I know there's something to it. Okay? It is something to it, but the something to it is outside of zodiac or zodiacal or astrological knowledge, which is occult knowledge, occult science, or, you know, all occult means is hidden. But we understand witchcraft, okay? That is the manipulation or the attempt to manipulate the world around you or people, or to control people. Witchcraft is a form of control. My apologies for the train. I'm on the other side of the tracks, Curtis. But the signs that the Most High speaks of have been hijacked. This is another idea. Again, the enemy has no new ideas. He cannot create. He is not a creator. He is a destroyer. So all he can do is take the things that were purposed by the Most High and attempt to twist them or distort them in some manner, and then feed them back to the people after the people have been blinded another way. And this is what has happened with this astrological thing, The Lord has revealed unto me, and why you see the something to it beyond the witchy stuff, okay? Meaning, you know, certain children born, you know, I have some little cousins that was born, all of them born like December 21st, 22nd, and 20th. And, you know, three girls. Things like that, you know, you wonder, well, you know, it just had to do with, well, yeah, it had to do with a lot of things. Well, you know, it's just the time that they were conceived. You know, maybe that's the same time of year all the time for the husband to be on vacation. Oh, you can rationalize anything, okay? But while he's on vacation, he tends to have this same notion around the same time of year. Again, because we all have some season, you know, some people say, my sister that's born in December says, and I never heard nobody say this, let alone no Detroiter, she like cold weather. That's what she say. I don't like cold weather. She was born in the midst of it. Did this have an effect on her? Okay, the season. Why, you know, couldn't we rationalize? Yes, we can rationalize that out, but we don't want to even flirt with anything that sounds like metaphysics or anything of that nature, but there is nature. Okay, all over the world you see the evidence of certain things coming from certain areas. Polar bears don't come from Africa. Okay? So everything does have its season and its reason. Okay. And oftentimes it's area. You know, certain things come from certain areas. Why is Idaho known for potatoes? Again, this is just the way, and the earth as a, you know, again, not trying to get on no, you know, there is no Gaia, but as a mass of one, like a body, different parts of the earth serve different purposes. You know, certain parts of the earth produce gold, and, you know, certain parts of the earth best for fishing, or, you know, for catching certain fish, or, you know, so, you know, certain parts of the earth are known for producing this for the earth. You know, we get certain things from China, and you know, always have. So there are certain areas that are supposed to supply certain things. Again, everything in decency and order, everything has its order, everything has its reason, everything has its season. But now the signs, this is the trick bag. When you begin to call yourself, I'm an Aries, you just said that you were a demon spirit. Gemini is Hermes, which was one of the fallen ones. Armus, Arman, became Hermes, and then Harm, Arm, as in armed forces, army, and then Hermes, which happens to be the patron spirit of doctors, and the trickster, a trickster spirit. So when you begin to make subconscious agreement with these signs, you say, for instance, and I'm gonna do mine and everybody else's, we all need to be loosed from any subconscious agreement with our sign, more than we know. Why? Because of the way that the subconscious works. Okay? Permission to speak freely. Can we talk? Can we kick it? Everybody gonna be all right? Now, I used to like a lot of artsy things because of background in music, you know, being an only child for so long, and then having to entertain yourself, drawing it from things of that nature. So I liked all that type of creative stuff, and it carried over into music. I liked Portishead, you know. Now, you know, they're like the witchy version of Jamiroquai. I used to say that. They was the witchy version of Jamiroquai. Mad witchy. But little did I know, Jamiroquai was witchy too, okay? I just didn't overstand that kind of witchy, quote unquote, at the time. Now, you know, as far as music, you know, this is just a side note for you know, folks that have commented on the tracks to the positive, and I guess to the negative too. But now, as far as music, all I can tell you is the father is the dopest of producers. And D Point knows the Most High. Okay, that's my brother from another mother, over 20 years, and he's a good man. Okay, as good as I've seen them come. But again, there's another type of witchy that escapes our radar oftentimes because it looks good. You know, the conscious thing, it looks good. We don't understand the witchiness of it. And I didn't understand it for a long, long time. It looks good and it sounds good on paper. Okay, you're concerned with the earth and with the situation in the earth. You know, maybe you're conscious of your culture, be it Irish or African. You're very into it and you're very intuitive now. All of a sudden you perceive things more than ever. You have returned to a more natural way. Perhaps you've changed your eating habits. Excellent thing. Okay, all these things look like pluses on paper. But along with that, 9 times out of 10, you're going to identify with your sign more than ever, because that's all a part of your spiritual awakening. It happened in the 70s, and it happened again during the neo-soul era. Okay, and then the neo-soul era kids had babies, and they passed on a lot of those same spirits. But again, these are spirits. You see the video game, Ares, God of War. This is a false god. These was beings that were worshipped, actual entities. So you will take on their characteristics subconsciously by making subconscious agreement. Some people make conscious agreement. It's on their shirt. Cancer, right across the front. Cancer rules the chest. So it's right across the front, right? I used to be very into it because I saw the original reason that there's something to it, you know? I saw this thing of, you know, this seasonal thing. My first girlfriend, before I knew anything about any of this, in high school, was born May 15th, I was born May 16th. I didn't go looking for that, that just happened. So there's another reason why things like that happen too, to help to pull you into a belief in astrology. These fallen angels are very, very slick, but you know, why would they just go through that length? Did they know I had some predetermined disposition that would make me more likely to gravitate toward it? Perhaps, of course they did. Of course they knew that. They knew of a grandfather and father dabbling in spiritism and conjuring, demonology. Okay, so you had that at play. But then always, the underlay, always is God's will and purpose. And God had a will and a purpose. He has a season for all things, a time, okay, a word in due season, okay? So he raises up certain things at certain times. You know, those who read the word, that don't sound strange at all. Okay, you overstand that, all right? Certain things are to be raised up in certain times. Well, also, you can look up in the sky and you can say, like Messiah said, you can discern by the sky that is, you know, what the weather's going to be. Okay, it's beyond that as well. Okay, the wise men looked up into the sky and they followed the star of Bethlehem as a sign. Okay, but again, what men did was they took God out of it and they began to empower themselves. The astrologer has power. Can tell you you're gonna have a good day or a bad day. Hello? He can control you. You see? So what you may see between you and your cousin that's born a couple days away from you is similarity of season. Okay, y'all coming out in a similar season, having similar effect on you as nurture and nature. Affects the whole thing. Still, it comes to both. I don't care what day you're born on, the way you're raised has the most effect on you. So that's why there's so much done in society to make this other thing have more effect on you in another way, in a spiritual way. Okay. So there is a subtle witchiness that's meant to slip into those of renewed consciousness, to those who have escaped the lower tier brainwash and behavior mod programming by agents of the adversary by way of media primarily. Astrological signs do the Agent Smith thing. They jump around like House of Pain. How can I be bound by the spirit of Taurus? And you can too. You can both say, I'm hard-headed. Having pride in stubbornness or pride in rebellion, which is witchcraft, it's not a good thing. And if it's only one spirit, Taurus, a Bacchanalian spirit, Bacchus. But if it's only one spirit, then how is it in so many places at once? Hello? You ever seen the anger spirit in here? We moving furniture, talking sharp at each other, and then you look around and it's over there too. It's across the street. You never seen it before? Obviously, you've never been to Detroit. Everybody mad. Fights might break out on several sides of the street. They jump around and multiply in that manner as things of energy. Okay? Yes, oh, the Lord is strong with me on this one. Call me Dark Vader by the time I'm through. Choke some insolent spirits out by the leading of the word and its reading. Comes straight from the word of God. Okay. How to rightly divide and decipher this mystery. Finally, after all this time in history, now we understand what it is. That's what it is. It's simple as that. So now what you have to do is put that other stuff back. You gotta loose yourself from all of the things you have accepted as a Pisces that, you know, you're supposed to be weirdish. You're the dreamer. You have accepted your hard head and your stubbornness as an Aries. You've accepted that you body. You've accepted that you like to get it in and show some skin as, you know, whatever, as Scorpio. Your sex drive is off the chain. You can't control it. You've accepted the spirit of lust. You've accepted that, hey, I'm cold-blooded, I'm cold on them. I'm cold on these. You've accepted it. Capricorn, I'm devilish, I'm cold-blooded. You've made subconscious agreement with these things. And I say subconscious agreement. Are you not aware of the subconscious mind and the way that it works? The subconscious mind is the recorder. It has recorded everything. It records forwards and backwards. Hello? Upside down. It remembers everything. And although you may not hold it in your conscious mind, if you have ever made that agreement, you need to disagree with it now. You need to renounce it. You need to renounce any agreement that you've made, any shirt you got, a keychain or whatever, anything that you know, you've ever... Even the thought crossing your mind, you don't understand what it means, give no place to the devil. All he needs is a place. Didn't say give no huge place. Give no place, not an inch. You give him an inch and a pinch, he'll take a mile with style. So any place in our mind where we've made some agreement with that, you know, or you may have heard, as a female, that your sign is male, huh? And it does it fuel your belief that, you know, you should wear wife beaters and things. Outside. Okay? And cornrows to the back. That's that look. Okay? Look like Cleo from Set It Off. But I digress. Okay, let's look at some things. Don't take pride in anything, but you know, anything. Don't take pride in nothing, but especially don't take pride in being stubborn or rebellious. You think you bad? Okay. Look at the demonic relationship between certain signs. There's a zodiac, quote unquote, clock that I've drawn before where you have one thing across from the other. The signs that are across from each other have a unique relationship one with another. Okay. Those are kindred spirits. Familiar spirits, familiar with one another and familiar with you too. For instance, Taurus and Scorpio. Okay, the demonic relationship between the Taurian demon and the Scorpion demon. Get over here! Be locked in Mortal Kombat, as exhibited on the zodiac clock. You have the same thing going on with Aries and quote unquote Libra. These are kindred spirits. We have the same thing going on with Pisces and so-called Virgo. Mm-hmm. And these spirits feed off of one another. This is why it's oftentimes you'll find somebody of one sign attracted to another person who has also made subconscious agreement with their sign. See, they've made that agreement somewhere. They share a spirit. They may share the spirit of stubbornness or lust or uncontrollable lust or fantasy lust. Okay, where they want to try out everything they ever thought of in their life. Okay? And, you know, other spirits. So, who among you is proud of your lustfulness? I'm freaky. Or, who among you is proud of your ability to be enraged? Dude, I'm telling you, man, I don't play no game, dog. I'm about it. I'm about to straight lose it, man. I'm finna go on the nut up in champ. I'll break everything. Somebody gonna try to hold you back. No. Don't hold me back. Now you done got mad at your boy. Now you gotta fight two Negroes, then the police. And Detroit versus everybody is just an expression. It's just an expression, nephew. Who among you takes pride in being cold? Cold-blooded. The cold is Capricorn. Now, you know, I feel for Capricorn because having subconscious agreement, you know, with that, I feel for those who've done that because you're having subconscious agreement with a bad, quote-unquote, sign, born under a bad sign, quote-unquote. Okay, so you make a subconscious agreement that not only are you cold, but you're being associated with the goat or the devil in tarot cards. Now, people in that season and I, we have a certain thing in common as far as that go. You know, the bad reputation of the, oh, that's that stubborn. You know, oh, that's that stubborn sign you like to argue, whatever, you know. But we, you know, my stepdaddy was one. The guy who raised me in the studio, he was one. Jerry Flynn. You know, we're real comfortable talking rough around each other, playfully, so. But, you know, these seasonal spirits, again, they know one another. You know, and the seasonal spirits of stubbornness seem to attack us both. And irreputable spirits, spirits that damage the reputation, okay, and the sense of self-identity and self-worth, okay? Self-esteem and reputation. To be associated with stubbornness and rebellion is witchcraft. To be associated with the devil is a burden to those bound with Capricorn spirit. Okay? You may let in Antichrist spirits if agreed with, okay? If you agree agree with that Capricorn. Yes, because subconsciously you're agreeing with the devil. You don't understand your subconscious mind, not even on the slightest level. The subconscious mind is the mind. That's the mind that functions like blinking in your heartbeat. You know, the automatic things. Okay, the things that you bury in the back of your mind, you know, in the back of your mind, generally people are referring to the subconscious mind, but the things that are buried back there are things that will manifest in your behavior. They will come out. Okay, they will burst forth and come out through your behavior, through your actions. So that's why making subconscious agreement with these signs, which is as simple as just letting the thought come. You know, you look at that keychain at the store, and you say, you know, it is me. Okay? Which we've all done. I've done this. We all, if we're honest, we all have, I think, allowed for this one to slip us. Okay? I mean, because it just really came to me to verbalize it in this way. Okay, so I think that that was what the Lord wanted me to say concerning that. Okay, some need to be loosed from the driven spirits. You know, you feel that this sign, you know, being under this sign, you're supposed to be real driven. Being under this sign, you're supposed to be real laid back, you know. So again, you're being bound by what they say concerning your sign. You cannot be bound by what witches and warlocks say concerning the signs. Okay? Concerning, you know, they looked at the seasons and they named the seasons after demons. Don't name yourself after no demon. Don't claim that. No false god. Aries is a false god. Cancer is a disease. They are all representations of Lucifer in different forms. Lucifer as the bull, Bacchus, okay? As the ram, backwards Mar, Mars and war, all, you can get all of that from the ram. Gemini is the trickster, double-faced, two-faced and double-minded. Janus. Cancer, the disease, the bug. You caught the bug, the flu, the bug, crab. You don't want to believe it's a bug? Eat it. Eat it up. As a roaring lion. Huh? Perpetrating virgin mother. Huh? Continue. Fake freedom and fake equality, Libra, and knowledge as God, the Libra, the book, but the balance, the fake balance, which makes him a hermaphrodite and which is bringing out this transsexual agenda, okay, equal male and female. And there's the monstrosity. I had a book called Star Names and Their Lore, and it taught more than I had ever learned about the history of the stars and the constellations and why they're named what they're named before. And it was very enlightening. It said that once Aries and Taurus were one constellation, and then they broke apart, and then they had to be named separately, but it was all just one at one time, Aries. And split into a positive and negative aspect. See, that's the Libra. Uh-huh. But Scorpio was not always a scorpion. It was some monster, some creature that did not exist zoologically, or that does not exist zoologically today. Some mythological creature, unnamed too. But going all the way back to Comet. In the hunter, of course, the arrows of the enemy, the hunter of your soul. Do you see it now? The goat, huh? The Aquarian age, huh? And the Antichrist at the end, the false fish. So each and every sign and symbol represents a demon, if you wish. You can call it a negative entity. But that's why they're all filled with negative energy. Okay? As much as, if not more, than the positive things about a sign, people talk about the negative. And you internalize that. You make subconscious agreement with that. That's the agreement Jesus Christ was talking about that we're to use in prayer. That subconscious agreement. That's all the way in the back of your mind to the front. You can say something consciously and not mean it subconsciously. You have to mean it all the way to the back of your mind. Because that's what matters most. And so, for most folks, they have made some agreement in the back of their mind, okay? So we had to look at the seasons by way of the Lord's purposes and Satan's purposes, okay? And yes, you know, certain signs, you take pride in your sign. You're proud to be a Leo. You're proud to be a Sag. So therefore, you have accepted all of the negative and the positive. And you've accepted the negative with a... You've added a degree of, you know, yes, that's a bad part of me. There's nothing I can do about it. It's just part of my sign. So you've resigned. You're not even going to fight that spirit. Be it stubbornness or whatever they may say about your sign. You may say, well, you know, hey, I'm just that way. I've done that with stubbornness. Okay? As you can see, I've come a long way. Pray for me. I'm a flawed man. I need your prayers. But all praise due always to the true and living God for giving this lesson and this idea. And I think that's all we're going to say concerning that. I think that that's been broken down in a decent way. Okay. Again, this is more for those who are, you know, more curious as to, well, why is there something to the signs? You deserve an answer. Okay? I was curious too. That's why there's something to the signs. Because of the way the Lord originally made it. He originally made for certain seasons to produce certain types of flowers, certain types of people. Okay? How creative of him. Were you not made of the dust of the ground from which flowers and plants grow? So it makes perfect sense. That's what it was. That's what it always was. And then here come the fallen ones, and they assign, or they teach man how to assign spirits to the seasons. Isn't that interesting? And then to call themselves after those spirits, calling those spirits into them, locking those spirits into them by accepting somewhere in the subconscious, hey, it's just a part of me, it's just another part of me. No, it ain't, Mike. Them some songwriter secret lyrics for you if you never checked them out. But okay, I think we're gonna stop here. Perhaps. One more little thought that came to me. Maybe I'll just share this. Okay. Someone was asking about proof of something. I think it was the songwriter secret, as a matter of fact. So right on time. Thank you, Most High. Person was saying, well, you know, it's interesting that I can't believe everything I hear. Of course you shouldn't. I didn't ask you to. And where's the proof? Some things not gonna have no proof or no paper trail. You know, woe unto a person that lives a life like that. The only things that are true are things that are documented. That's a sad life. Because the things that are documented are manipulated. You can't trust them. So that's not wise. But also too, like, for certain things, people expect for a whistleblower to manifest. This came to me. A person who has truly been converted by the blood of Jesus is not likely to come out and name names maliciously. Why? Because that person is likely engaged in forgiveness. This is why a certain smoking gun proof is hard to come by, if you'll ever come by it, ever, truly. And that's why we must be the believing and seeing type. We must operate in Hebrews 11 and 1 faith, not the seeing and believing type. And then this last thought, the insecure man versus the real alpha male. It's going to be really quick. Think about the secret societies. Look at them dudes. Ain't none of them lady killers. Daddy Rockefeller and Daddy Ford both look like dried up vampires. Look at Albert Pike. He has a problem with obesity, said Cat Williams. Look at Big Ben, Ben Franklin. Now, he had that coin and that good mouthpiece. A perfect combination. Deadly. But he looked like hell fire club material. Wink. It's the taking out and taking over of the dominant male, the alpha male, pledging to let some insecure metrosexual boss up on you just for status, a little taste of status, is not the way of a truly dominant male. A truly dominant male does not seek that type of approval. They don't have to. They receive it naturally from males and females. So the title alpha male has been hijacked. It's time to take it back. Man, don't run nor get ran. Please, man. Man, please. Thank you very much for listening. We want to say a prayer now and just ask that the Lord would loose us from any subconscious agreement or soul ties to our signs, okay? We're going to just focus on that. We have extensive prayers to loose all of the different forms of magic and witchcraft and wizardry and sorcery out there on the list of spirits to bind video. So for this one, we're just going to ask in the authority of the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, we ask that you would please forgive us for our sins and please hear our prayer. In the authority of the name of Jesus, Father, we ask that you would loose us from any agreement that we have made with our zodiac sign or with any astrological sign or any spirit of the prince of the power of the air, water, earth, or fire. And in the authority of the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord God, where that you would loose us right now, Heavenly Father, from our zodiac sign, that you would loose us from the spirit that is named for our zodiac sign, that you would loose us from any soul tie to astrology or to our sign, quote unquote, or to the spirit that we call our sign. We ask, Lord God of Word, that you would loose us from the mights, powers, dominions, principalities, spirits of wickedness in high places, in low places, in us and in our subconscious mind, associated with our quote unquote zodiac sign. Loose us, Heavenly Father, from every demonic energy or force, Heavenly Father, that has been bound to us concerning the spirits of our zodiac sign. Loose us from every spirit that has been bound to us because of our agreement with our zodiac sign. And bind up all of the aforementioned spirits, entities, energies, forces, demons, fallen ones, mites, dominions, principalities, powers, or spirits of wickedness in high places, and bind them all in everlasting, unbreakable chains, and cast them all out of us, and cast them all down into the pit of the abyss below the ground, the place of Tartarus, outer darkness, or wherever Jesus Christ prefers, because Jesus Christ has done it. He is our Lord and Savior, our deliverer, in whom we trust. We touch an agreement, and as we've decreed it, we believe it. Therefore, according to your word, Heavenly Father, in Matthew 18 and 18 through 18 and 20, Matthew 21 and 22, and Isaiah 55 and 11. We've received it. It is so, and it is done. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Glory be unto the Father. Praise to Jesus Christ, Lord, Savior, King, and Son. Shalom. One.